Safety relays are the devices that implement safety functions. In event of a hazard, a safety relay will work to reduce the risk to an acceptable level. When an error occurs, the safety relay will initiate a safe and reliable response. Each safety relay monitors a specific function. By connecting them together to other safety relays, one can achieve total monitoring of a machine or plant. Let's start understand more about safety relay wiring. This is an electrical diagram of a safety relay. As you can see that this is two-channel relay. This means that it can monitor two safety circuits. Terminal S11 and S12 is an input for the channel 1. It can be a door safety switch of a machine or a laser safety curtain. Terminal S21 and S22 is an input for the channel 2. It can also be an emergency stop or any other safety device. Terminal S33 and S34 is a start signal for the safety relay. If we give 24 volt DC signal on this terminal once, it will start monitoring channel 1 and channel 2. As we know that every control panel has a master control relay or a contactor which is used to cut off the power to the critical devices in case of emergency. This contactor power is connected to the output terminal of the relay 13, 14 or 23, 24 terminals. In case one of the safety channels 1 or 2 signal breaks, the safety relay will turn open the contacts 13 and 14 or 23 and 24 respectively. Since we have connected master control contactor or a relay to these safety terminals, safety relay will cut off the power for this contactor and turn off the power circuit in the control panel. Now let's do the wiring of the safety circuit. First, we will connect 24 volt DC at A1 and A2 terminal. This is the power for the safety relay. I have connected a green push button on S33 and S34 terminals to give a start signal to the relay. Next, I have connected two red push buttons on channel 1 and channel 2. This push button will simulate the signals from the safety devices. Remember one thing, these signals must be used with the normal closed contacts. Now we will give the power to the master control relay or the contactor. We can make a series circuit for the output contacts of the safety relay so that if any one of the safety channel 1 or 2 fails, it will turn off the MCR or master control relay. Now we have finished the basic wiring for the simulation of our safety relay. Let's see the working of the safety relay on a real hardware. First, we will power on the circuit. Right now, power LED is on and channel 1 and channel 2 LED is off. This means that right now the control relay is not monitoring these channels. To start monitoring, we will give a start signal to the safety relay by pressing the green push button. Now, channel 1 and channel 2 both LEDs are on. Because we have used red push button with normally closed contacts and 24 volt signal is already coming on the both input channels. Output terminals of this safety relay are also turned on, or master control relay or MCR is also turned on. Now if we turn off the channel 1 by pressing red push button once, the channel 1 LED turned off. And MCR or master control relay also turned off. Now if we turn off the channel 2 by pressing the red push button once, the channel 2 LED also turns off. Now to start again the safety relay, we have to give 24 volt DC pulse signal on the start terminal of the safety relay. As you can see that the safety relay turns on again and start monitoring channel 1 and channel 2. And our master control relay is also turned on. Let's repeat the same cycle once again. Now let's understand one more thing in this safety relay. If we turn off one of the channel by pressing the red push button, the channel 2 turns off. Now if we try to start the relay by pressing the green push button, the relay is not starting again. This is because of the channel 1. The channel 1 is still on. We have to turn off the channel 1 also by pressing our input button. Once both channels are off, if now I try to start the relay by pressing the green push button, it will reset the safety relay and safety relay will start again monitoring the input channel 1 and channel 2. So this is the today's tutorial regarding the safety relays. I hope you like it. Please share and comment. Till next video, take care and goodbye.